Today I'm showing you how to make animated LED strips in your props and cosplay. This is specifically the four LED strips known as Neopixels. The first thing you need is the LED strip. These are addressable LED strips and you can buy them anywhere. I like to purchase mine on AliExpress, but you can also get them from Amazon or Adafruit. I also got these from Adafruit. It's an Arduino Nano Every. An Arduino Nano is a perfect option to create a small chip that will tell your addressable LED strips what to do and what color they need to be. It's basically a mini computer and it has a little micro USB port on it. Without a chip, these addressable LED strips are not going to work. For power, I'm using a stripped USB cable, which these are already stripped and I buy them like this, but you can also just get a regular USB cable and cut it up. And I use a power bank. Any power bank will work, but a power bank with more output will be able to power bigger projects for longer. For tools, I have my standard soldering equipment and a wire stripper, plus some heat shrink tubing to protect my connections. Any kind of electronic soldering iron will work just fine. But this is my little soldering station, where I can use the little grippers to hold my projects and adjust the temperature a little. Now I'm going to show you how to wire this up, but this is without having a project in mind. So if you need to install this in a project, you need to think about extending it using extra wires and stuff. These LED strips can be bought in different sizes and densities. All of them will work the same way if they use the same type of addressable LED strip. Every strip will come with a JST plug and two loose wires. One at the start and one at the end. Every addressable LED strip has little arrows on the strip, which tells you which direction the data is going, because the data connection can only be inserted from one side. So you need to make sure that the data is always coming from the little computer chip to the LED strip in the right direction. Especially when you're cutting up these LED strips, you can get mistaken for this, and then the LED strip is not going to work. For starters, we're cutting off the end of the LED strip. There's an extra plug here that will fit right at the start. So we're going to use this to solder it to our Arduino Nano. This way we can remove the Arduino Nano from our project and be able to upload programs to it more easily. And also we can use the Arduino Nano for more than just one project by saving and uploading different programs every time we need it. I'm stripping off the bare wires that I just cut off with my wire stripper. You don't need a wire stripper, but it's a few bucks at Harbor's Freight, so it's really convenient. I used to do this with scissors, and it's just so much easier with a wire stripper. Now we have our plug wire stripped and ready to go and solder it to our mini computer. Our Arduino Nano has all sorts of labels. Our Arduino Nano has a bunch of connections with labels that will tell you what it's used for. The only things we need is the 5-volt port, the ground connection, and a data connection. You can see there's multiple data connections to choose from. I'm starting with the red wire, which is the positive wire, and I'm going to connect this to the 5-volt input on my Arduino Nano. Because the power bank that we're using as a power supply has a regulated 5-volt output, we can use this 5-volt port on our Arduino Nano. So I'm going to insert my wire through the 5-volt port and make sure that it's in there. Just make sure that none of the wires are touching any of the other inputs. I'm wrapping the wire around a little bit, so it's nice and steady for the moment I'm soldering this point. So I'm going to take my solder and my hot iron and hold it together to create a little soldering point. Now the next step is to add the ground. This is the negative wire, and it's going into the ground input on my board. Again, make sure that none of the wires are split. I'm gonna connect it the same way I did with the positive wire, making sure I don't overlap any of the other ports. Just a tiny bit of solder is plenty. Now the third connection is the data connection. You can pick any D port on the other side of the board to add it to. I usually use D2 because it's just the closest to the rest of the wires. This Arduino Nano is now perfectly prepped to connect to any addressable LED strips that you might have to use for your projects. Because of the plug, it will be easy to upload new code and connect to any sort of LED strip that you need. Now, the next step is to add power to the LED strip. Every addressable LED strip has these bare two wires, which the white one that I'm stripping right now is the negative wire, and the red one is the positive wire. I'm going to be connecting my USB cable to these two wires to provide power to both the Arduino Nano and the LED strip. I'm going to solder these wires, and I'm going to protect them with some heat shrink. This will make sure that the connections are not going to be touching each other. You can also use electrical tape or something like hot glue, but I find that heat shrink is the most durable and clean way to do this. I'm picking a small, short one, and I'm picking a larger one. The short one is going to connect one of the wires to keep it apart from the other connection, and the large one is going to be encompassing the entire wire, so I get a nice and durable connection. Now it's time to connect the positive and negative wires together. Of course, positive wire goes to the same positive wire, so red to red. If you're struggling to connect two loose wires, use two clamps or thin the wires a little bit on both sides before holding it together with your soldering iron. I'm going to slide my piece of heat shrink over the connection. This will make sure that it's not going to touch the negative connection and create a short. Now I'm going to connect the negative wire. When the connection is done, I tug on it a little bit to make sure that it is all soldered nice and straight. And I'm going to slide over my big piece of heat shrink over the entire connection to make it nice and durable. I'm not going to use heat to shrink it yet, because I want to test the connection first, otherwise I will have to cut it up again. I'm going to connect my Arduino Nano with the plug, and then put in my power bank. It should turn on the Arduino Nano immediately with a green light. This is the drawing of the assembly that I've made. The power forks off for powering both the Arduino Nano and the LED strip. And you can extend these wires or add switches for on and off in between. Because the Arduino Nano is not programmed yet, the LED strips are not going to work. Next step is to upload some programming to the Arduino Nano using the micro USB port on this chip. You'll need a computer to connect and upload programming to it. This is the app that I'm using to upload programming and codes and patterns for my Arduino Nano. It's called Arduino. Because this app uses a lot of different programming, we're going to have to search for LED strips first. These are called addressable LED strips, and you can use all sorts of pre-made patterns using the Neopixel library. Once you've installed this library in your Arduino app, you'll be able to find it in the examples menu and find a bunch of different pre-made examples. To test our circuit, I'm going to just upload one of the easy examples without changing too much. You can read through this app and see what else you can do to improve your circuit, but I found that none of these steps are really necessary for smaller projects. The most crucial parts that you need for your own circuits and that you need to pay attention to is the data pin that you used for your connection. I used data pin 2, so I'm going to change it to 2. Also, this is for the amount of LEDs that you have in your project. I'm going to put it to 60, and that is fine for now because I'm just testing. When you scroll down, you can check out all these patterns that are going to be used in the example. And if you want to, you can later adapt these patterns for your own use by changing the colors or deleting stuff that you don't need. The segment where it says loop will tell your app to run all these patterns in succession and then repeat them. So just delete the patterns you don't want or change it. The standard brightness is fairly low, so make this a higher number if you need a higher brightness for your project. I'm pretty happy with the example code for now. I'm just going to leave most of it as is, just for testing. I'm going to plug in my Arduino Nano with the micro USB cable, and it should show up here immediately. Then select the board, and then you can upload your code using the upload button. It's going to take a while to upload it to your Arduino Nano board. The Nano's every that I'm using specifically is going to throw this exception code, but it's not going to make a difference for you. Now, my Arduino Nano has the required programming loaded onto the chip. So as soon as I plug it in and the battery's plugged in, it's going to run the example code that is uploaded on the chip. And as you can see, it works perfect. It's going to loop through all the example patterns that were in my loop. Now you can extend these wires to suit your project, or you can add an on-off switch for your USB power bank as well. Because this roll has about 500 LEDs, it's not going to reach the center, because I only selected 60 LEDs as the number in my app. I want to show you another library that I use very often for my props, which is the FastLED library. You can also install this through the libraries online. The fire example is one of examples that I use very often for any kind of cool props that needs like a fiery effect. There's lots of things you can customize in this, such as color, speed, and size. Again, I changed the data pin to the one I'm using for my Arduino Nano. You can read through the program and it's going to tell you exactly what you need to change to customize your fire effect. I want to change the colors, so I'm going to select a different color from this list. You can also customize your own colors. I want to use this blue fire effect for Illyria cosplay, so I'm picking the blue color. And I'm going to upload it to my Arduino Nano. Again, I press the upload button and it's going to change all the programming on my new Arduino Nano to only run this effect. I'm going to plug it back in, plug the battery in, and it should start booting up and start the animation immediately. This is a fire effect. And it's going to flicker and look like a fire if you use things like fabric and foam to cover it up. You can use all sorts of custom patterns to make fancy props and weapons. I use the fire effect as well in this LED prop, for example. I hope it was informative. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments.